things that are friendly. I am Professor Brassthorn. If you are hearing this, then you were drawn here by forces that would lie outside the conjecture of the petty and the contemporary. No matter how innocuous your sojourn to this mental destination, there was indeed a clandestine reason for it, I assure you. Tonight, I'd like to conduct an experiment. Would you care to join me? Most individuals of delicate sensibilities are put off by my plague walker mask, so this aether casting transmission should do nicely. But I can tell without seeing your face that you are a strong individual who's decided to brave the dark airwaves this night. A perfect candidate with an open mind. So rarely outside the realm of academia do we get to indulge in our exploratory predilections, wouldn't you agree? If you are wearing headphones or auxiliary auditory modules, you are well on your way. Otherwise, if you are listening through a phonograph bell, please increase the volume to your comfort level. Now, before we begin, I'd like you to lie back and truly relax. Perhaps close your eyes. This will help you clear your sensory input and focus on the darkness of your mind. This is where the journey will take place. I feel it is prudent to tell you that this experiment is to allow your mind to channel what is referred to as a sublimated awareness and brain activity. Humanoids are inherently flawed by limitation as to bind form to our shape within our construct of flesh. However, there are infinite channels and passageways that we are able to access with the proper stimuli, waveforms, and sensorium that our bodies block to allow constructive scope on our surveying expanse. An awareness only as broad as the aperture of our perspective. Hitherto, this prismatic influence can still be felt and manipulated if one undergoes the means to opening the door. Whether by drink, drug, or even idea, it is indeed very easy to see how our simple reality can fall into the cosmic depths when one foregoes perception and invokes translucency of the mind. You will learn to accomplish just that with this experiment. And now, if you had your eyes closed, you should be seeing an opalescent swirl of dissonant colors amid the black by this time. This is normal. Perhaps your eyes are flickering a bit, trying to remain closed. This is only your mind attempting to prevent you from diving in too deep. Defense mechanisms. Do not fight or tense up. Only relax, and let me assure you that you are in a place of peace and safety within your own mind, despite the fervent chaos of the day-to-day. Now hold still. I'm going to give you something to help you see. This vial of glowing blue liquid I've injected into the aether caster is a unique compound of effervescent quality. The liquid reacts to the outside air and emits a small hyperfrequency that is typically inaudible to most ears. Another defense mechanism of our evolution to prevent us from overexposure of sound waves. Now I must warn you, the effects of this liquid come with certain somatic symptoms. Just remain calm and continue to peer into the veil. The symptoms have been known to produce no effect on about 87% of the patients who have undergone this experiment. However, the other 13 have reported hearing a slight ringing sound. And some have reported symptoms of slight headache, unease, nausea, and nervousness. Most symptoms become prevalent the longer you are exposed to it. In times of about 10 seconds. We are roughly 30 seconds in now. Feeling anything? Good. That means you are listening to your body better than most of the benign souls who wander this mortal plane. If not, do not worry. Your reaction to this liquid's hyperfrequency is not necessary to the success of the experiment. I assure you that the effects are temporary, and you have the freedom to turn off this experiment whenever you wish. Simply remove your hearing apparatus, and the side effects will subside in a matter of moments. But you are strong, so let us continue down the rabbit hole. Allow my voice to accompany you through the dark. A narrator digging in the graves of your dream soil. The nether void of human consciousness harbors a different experience for everyone. By this time, the waveform should have given you passage to a form of manifestation. Patients who have undergone this experiment have reported numerous experiences. Everything from slowly traveling to locales they associate with their astral plane, meeting spirit animals, manipulating the time stream and going back to long ago memories, and even communion with the dead. These are minor examples. You should focus on your own experience. With repeat of this experiment, you may grow more and more accustomed to falling through the veil of your mind. What are you seeing right now? Every experience is as unique as you are, and the hyperfrequency should be taking effect to help alleviate the unbalanced channeling. If you feel a slight headache, do not fight it. Instead, embrace the pain and try to find the source as you navigate through the obsidian blackness behind your eyes and out into much deeper constructs beyond the realm of distance. Would you be surprised if I told you it was not the sound causing the headache? Rather, it is your mind suggesting a song to your subconscious, like a lyrical symphony of electromagnetic communication. We are bombarded by invisible forces all throughout our day. And you have spent years crafting walls in your mind to stave off the overkill of sensory input. It is perfectly normal if you start to feel a bit uncomfortable. It is only your mind slipping off the flesh and wrapping itself in the nebulous gloom. Do you see something now? Hold on to that. I'm going to increase the dosage. I think you're ready. resonant and should help bring a sharpness to the imagery you are witnessing. Like lenses being switched in a phoropter to help attune your mental vision. It should begin to clarify your washes of color and depth. If you continue to hear ringing beyond your comfort level, do not be afraid to stop. If you experience fear, do not be afraid to stop. You have done well to make it only this far. Now, if you have made it to this point in the experiment, around this time your body should be very relaxed. And though your mind may feel the fathomless distance away, you still retain complete dominance. All of your senses act in concert to recognize higher awareness. And sometimes you can forego them to augment the senses that you do not use regularly. This is a form of spiritual psychochemical calibration. By this time, you should be receiving signals. Some patients have reported them as songs, symbols, secrets, or manifestations of metaphorical arcane lore. These unique tangibilities are not meant to be understood right now. That is for your critical mind to decipher later. For now, you are to absorb them and thank your memory for keeping them. These gifts are yours. Long after this experiment has ended, may you behold these whispers of knowledge. Gather up what you can. It is time we go further. This is a shepherd tone. It is an auditory illusion of a repeating sound that gives the effect of constant tonal descent. Your mind will begin to take this as a form of precipitable momentum, pulling you down below your hovering and lofty spirit scope. This is just one of many ways we can dive under to the catacombs, where the primordial gray matter that hovered in your eyes at the beginning of this experiment comes from. Many patients have reported to exhibit mild nausea at the sound. Their body reacting to an imaginary loss of equilibrium. Understand that it is only your mind that is falling, and you will not require a safety net. Learn to plunge and tumble downwards like a falling star. Soon, the indigo soup of the deeper fathoms will slow your momentum, and you will come nestled in the amniotic brine of intertransitory flux. This compoundless gestalt of shadow and groaning emptiness is the moors of creation. Here you can witness the heartbeat of the multiverse. space. This place is where resides between construct and veracity. This is a place where mortal form and objective flesh do not coalesce. A place whereby visiting, you have earned the title of Dreamstrider. Legends of our meager understanding, since time granted creatures with memory, have honored this incomprehensible tangibility you now behold. Beyond the line where the physical model of our existence ebb and flow, from natural to supernatural, give credence to this glossary. Time is a novelty, tracing side effects to every component of your fractal sliver, to the stained facet of the dissolved ashes belonging to your multiversal crematory. Those temporal ashes are now blown into the wastelands of omnificent grandeur. I'm afraid my words cannot hold much sway as a cognitive beacon any longer, lest they rend you asunder. Let your mind wilt, and you may behold the final providence. Imagine.